Hey, GamingWithMelkor6925 here, bringing you another Clash Royale video. Now, before we go any further, guys, if you've not subscribed, do me a big favour and hit that subscribe button. If you've not hit the like button, hit the like button as well. So, guys, what I'm going through today is a deck spotlight. This is the deck I'm currently using, which involves the Golem, the Barbarians, the Goblin, the Poison Spell, the Arrows, the Spear Goblins, the Baby Dragon, and the Elixir Collector. Now, this deck has done me proud and has gone 10 straight wins. That's right, 10 straight wins in my first 10 battles. Now, I'm actually doing the recording of this with the audio. Actually, it's a later point because I couldn't do the recording while actually doing the video, guys. But what I'm doing now, I'm just going to show you a few of those actual replays. I'm just going to show you the actual battle log first. So here they are. These are the 10 victories. 3-0, a 2-0, a 1-0, a 1-0, a 3-0, a 3-1, a 3-2, a 3-0, a 3-1, and a 3-1 victory. Now, I actually decided to use this deck because I got beat by a very similar deck. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through a few replays through. Yeah, I'm not going to talk you through them all, because quite frankly, I can't remember exactly what happens, but these are some of the ones I chose. Now, this is actually the first replay that I actually, the first battle I actually completed. Now, I wasn't really sure what I was doing, so, because I'd only played against the deck, or part of the deck once, I'd only trialed the deck once as well. So, as you can see, I sent down that Golem first, sent down that Osiris to take that down. Then Spear Goblins behind, just to take some damage onto that tower, which gets it down nice and low, I think, to remind myself. But it is a new deck, so it's not always that easy. So again, that poison spell coming into effect I find quite useful. It's good at taking down a large number of those little pesky troops. Again, use these arrows, take down them. As you can see, I've got that elixir collector saving that elixir so I can drop that golem. The main point of the golem, well, this deck really, is to get the elixir collector down, get that golem up front, get a few troops behind it, and let them plow into that tower. I find it very effective to get the barbarians behind it, because if you can get them to a tower without actually taking any damage, or be able to actually focus down the tower, they can do some serious damage to one of those towers very, very quickly. So as you can see, that was a fantastic start, taking down the three crowns. So I'm just going to look for another replay to actually show you. This one here was, I believe, a solid 1-0 victory. Oh, no, is it not going to be that one? Oh, no, sorry. We're going against the 2-0 victory, which was my second game. This was against a level 8, and it had the Dark Prince in it, a card which I was a bit skeptical about. Now, as you can see, they're going to do some serious damage to my tower before I even get started. I've just got that Elixir pump down, and I'm going to put another Elixir pump down here. I'm going to put it in front of that tower to obviously try and protect the tower slightly. Stick that Golem down up front. He's obviously going to not get very far, but as you can see, I had a massive push going behind him, which was able to allow me to take down that tower very, very quickly. So, attempting to push down the opposite side now, send the Golem down again, use those Barbarians to protect the other tower, stick the Dragon, the Barbarians, and the Spear Goblins behind to watch that second tower go down. Now, all that's a matter of time is, can we take down that crown tower? No, we can't. But as you can see, a very solid two-star victory. This deck is very versatile in both offense and defense. The only card, one of the only cards you can't really use on defense is that Golem. All the other cards will work well on defense, including the poison spell. And also using that elixir collector in front of your towers, potentially, as a barrier to stop them getting there. Now, I did have the low battery there. Oops. I should always charge it before I do a video or before I do a recording. But what it was, I wanted to actually record this after I got those straight 10 victories so I didn't forget. So again, there goes that poison spell, taking out a multitude of troops. Now, I'm not going to bother too much about that princess or the wizard. Down goes that golem. Now, I'm just going to start building that elixir, so I'm going to big push going down this left-hand side. So, next thing, barbarians behind, followed by the dragon. Now, can you see that pekka there? Look at that pekka getting pushed all the way back. Boom, that pekka doesn't stand a chance and melts. Can you see that tower? Melts as well. This guy knows he's got no chance. Look at all those troops onto that tower. That crown tower is just going to melt like that. Fantastic three stars. So, so quick if played correctly. So let's just have a look at a couple more replays here. Now, there was one victory here where I won 3-1, which I shouldn't have won. The opponent played it wrong at the last second, and I will show you what I mean by that. If he had not played it, he would have had a one crown victory against me. But because he played a card, it meant I went on to actually win. Now, it's the Hog Rider and the Valkyrie coming up there. I don't use my Elixir very well. He uses his freeze very well there. Obviously, I dropped my Goblins down, who just that Valkyrie just absolutely decimated. Obviously, I'm going to drop that second pump in front just to protect the tower slightly. Obviously, that fireball did some serious damage to it. But it's one of those things. You're going to get those fireballs coming in. Now, as you can see, that Hog Rider, he's going to go down, nearly taking that tower. Now, that tower is going to go in during the course of this battle, and you will see what I mean by how I shouldn't have won this. As you can see, though, I'm doing a nice bit amount of damage to that tower now, which will put me just in the lead on damage and on the XP chase as well. At this point, there come the tears. Well, I'll throw them straight back at you. So we're going into the last 60 seconds. Let's see what we can actually do. Down goes that tower. Boom. Now, I'm in a deep amount of trouble here. Wasted poison spell, really. Now, unfortunately, as you can see, combination of that Tesla and that thing is slowing me down. Now, what you're going to do, I'm slowing it down so you can actually see in real time. Now, what's going to happen? Look at the health on that golem. So close, but only 209 HP. He uses that freeze with 6 seconds to go. I cannot win this game now. But look at this. He plays them goblins. Boom! With 3 seconds left to go, them goblins hit me, exploding my golem to take out the tower. If he hadn't have done that, game over, I lost 1-0. So as you can see, I'm pushing down this left-hand side now, hitting that Tesla, trying to get to that tower as quick as I can. Now, unfortunately, I do get this tower so far down, but unfortunately, that fireball is the thing. So I changed my mind, I'm going for the crown tower. He's pushed all his troops down that left, I'm going for that tower now. With 8 seconds left, managed to take it down. The immense amount of damage you can do with the goblins behind and a couple of spear goblins as well is immense. 7 seconds on the clock, 3-1 victory in a battle I should have lost. Thank you very much, my opponents, for getting overconfident there and dropping those goblins when he shouldn't have. So another victory here. This is a very similar deck. Golem versus Golem. Not sure quite how to play this, especially with the Ice Wizards, which I'm still yet to get myself. Now, as you can see, going straight for that tower, they are doing some serious damage to that tower, and I'm not even in the running here. Now, here comes that Hog Rider. Luckily, he doesn't really get through. My little guy's coming, but as you can see, down goes that tower. Boom, just like that. I'm in a world of hurt here. Luckily, I've got my guys on their tower, and we are one for one. All the matter now is who can actually take the victory here. Now, so I place that Elixir Collector there just for a bit of added protection. Down goes that poison spell just to do some serious damage to some of those troops. Fantastic spell on both offense and defense if you can slow down your opponents. Here comes the golem down there, right? I'm going up the left. I'm going to take mine out with these barbarians. Obviously, still going to take some damage on that tower, but not that much. Now, they've put a prince in defense. Not the most wisest of moves, but here comes that freeze spell again. Oh, it's not looking good at this point. Now, I have got some damage off that tower, off their crown tower, but they have taken down mine. Now, as you can see, I've managed to do a massive counter push down the opposite side, which screws that down. Now, they're going for mine. I'm not stopping. I'm just going to keep on pushing, hoping I can take the tower before they do. It's just a matter of will of who does it. I have more troops on the ground and are able to take down that tower. So, guys, that's this deck going 10 for 10. That's the Golem, the Barbarians, the Collector, the Goblins, the Poison Spell, the Arrows, the Spear Goblins, and the Baby Dragon. With an average elixir cost of 4.1. Fantastic deck. 10 out of 10 victories to date. So, guys, that's it from me. If you like what you see, comment below, let me know. Like I said before, guys, if you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. And I'll see you gamers next time. Take care.